Here is an image of a fishing boat in one of Central Asia's saltwater lakes. And here is an image of a deserted bioweapons facility located in a toxic desert in Central Asia. This is the story of how human activity, with blatant disregard for nature, turned a large and vibrant ecosystem into a wasteland in the course of a few decades. Welcome to... The Aral Sea, which is technically a saltwater lake, lies in a depression in Central Asia, east of the Caspian Sea, in an area characterized by desert continental climate, with hot summers, cold winters, and sparse rainfall. At an average of 4 inches per year, the rain compensates for only a fraction of the water evaporation of the lake. Thus, the Aral's main source of water are the rivers Sir Darya in Kazakhstan and the Amu Darya in Uzbekistan. Despite that, the lake is the fourth largest in the world, with an area of 68,000 square kilometers. This, however, is an image from the 1960s. This is what the lake looks like today. At about 10% of its area from the 1960s, the Aral Sea is mostly gone and widely considered as one of the most dramatic examples of ecological disasters caused by human activities. Despite the rough climate in the region, the disappearance of the lake was not due to a natural phenomenon, but rather the product of geopolitics. You see, today, the lake is located in the territory of Uzbekistan and Kazakhstan. However, from 1925 to 1990, this was the territory of the USSR. Back in 1948, 3 years after the end of the Second World War, the Communist Party began an ambitious campaign to rebuild the Soviet Union's economy by unanimously passing the Great Plan for Transformation of Nature, an initiative supported by Joseph Stalin himself. According to the propaganda of the time, nature itself would be subject to the party's commands. It was the same propaganda that claimed that major rivers would become machines rather than flowing uselessly downstream. In an attempt to make cotton a major export of the USSR, the Soviets diverted the two rivers that fed the Aral Sea for the irrigation of massive plantations in the dry but nutrient-rich Central Asian desert. Large-scale irrigation canals were built, but their poor quality made them very inefficient, with large volumes of water leaking out or evaporating before reaching their destination. As a result, by the 1960s, between 20 and 60 cubic kilometers of water that used to replenish the sea were being diverted away each year. Uzbekistan did manage to become the largest exporter of cotton in the world in 1988, however, this came at a great cost. By 1989, the Aral Sea water level dropped by 50 feet from its 1960s level. As a result, the remaining water contained 3 times higher concentration of salt, effectively killing the lake's fauna and the remaining fishing industry, which once provided sustenance for many in the region. Given the crop rotation was not used in the plantations around the lake, soil depletion began to take place. To counter that effect, massive quantities of pesticides and fertilizer were required. As a result, the runoff from the fields washed the excess chemicals into the shrinking sea, creating severe pollution. As the sea dried out, the salt and chemicals that were once dissolved in the water were picked up by the winds and spread across the region by dust storms, impacting the local inhabitants and agriculture. To make matters worse, the once called Vozrozhdeniye Island, located in the Aral Sea, hosts a Soviet bioweapon testing facility. Over the years, this place became a true living nightmare, causing outbreaks of smallpox, plague, typhus, and other exotic diseases. But that's not all. The island is also the final resting place for the largest anthrax stockpile in human history. This happened in 1988, when the Soviets decided to get rid of their arsenal. Between 100 to 200 tons of anthrax slurry was hastily dumped in pits and forgotten about. Thankfully, those pits have since been neutralized. However, half a century of open-air testing has left the entire island contaminated. This is a problem that has only been amplified by the drying lake and the resulting dust storms. After the breakup of the USSR, the regional governments tried to counter the declining sea levels through policies, but the lack of coordination resulted in further water depletion. Eventually, the shoreline receded further and the lake split into pools. In Kazakhstan, the North Aral Sea was preserved due to the construction of a 12-kilometer long dike across the narrow channel that connects the North Lake to its neighbor to the south. The return of the North Aral Sea has in turn fueled the revival of the fishing industry in the local towns. Across the border in Uzbekistan, the story is very different. The country's greater reliance on cotton has effectively stalled the lake restoration projects. Water does remain in the West Aral Sea, which has some replenishment from groundwater, but as of 2015, the eastern basin of the South Aral Sea has completely dried up. Unfortunately, the future of the Aral Sea is highly dependent on political support, which is currently lacking. Now that the cotton industry has been so well established in the region, the socio-economic pressure to preserve it is simply too great to overcome. There is a saying in Central Asia, where there is no water, there is no life. This is sadly becoming the reality for millions of people in the region. What was once the fourth largest lake in the world is now a true living nightmare, where miles of toxic desert surround an island that hosts the deadliest diseases known to man. The Aral Sea crisis has not only led to a wide-scale environmental degradation, it has become a human crisis.